Hey, I'm Miss Danielle, and today we have a special guest, Mr. David, teaching with us. Mr. David is one of our student ministry directors for our junior high students. Help me welcome him to our studio with a big RESkids hello.
What's up, RESkids? It's so cool to be here with you.
Today we're going to begin a new lesson and start the story of Jesus' journey to the cross. But first, let's lift our voices to prepare us for God's Word, because singing together is one of the ways we tell God who He is and celebrate with Him.
If you're excited to sing together, give me a yup yup.
Yup yup!
Get up, RESkids. Let's sing and praise the Lord together.
Yes! Worshiping God this way always makes my heart ready for His Word.
Me too. I'm fired up to watch this video about the awesome way Jesus went to Jerusalem.
His triumphal entry. Take a peek at this video clip.
It was time to celebrate Passover, a special time to remember how God had freed His people from slavery in Egypt. Many Israelites had traveled to Jerusalem to celebrate God's amazing rescue. Jesus and His disciples were among the people who traveled to Jerusalem. When they neared Bethphage and Bethany near the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two of His disciples ahead into a village. "As soon as you enter the village," Jesus told them, "you will find a young donkey tied there. No one has ever sat on it. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone says to you, 'Why are you doing this?' say, 'The Lord needs it.'" The disciples did as Jesus asked. As they untied the donkey, its owners asked why. "The Lord needs it," they said. Then they brought the donkey to Jesus, threw their robes onto the donkey, and helped Jesus get onto it. People spread their robes along the road for Jesus, and others spread palm branches cut from the fields. The whole crowd praised God with a loud voice for all the miracles they had seen. "Hosanna," they said. "Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest heaven." The word Hosanna means save now. The people welcomed Jesus as their promised king. They hoped he would save them from the Romans. Some religious leaders asked Jesus to tell his disciples to be quiet. Jesus answered, "If they did not praise me, the rocks would praise me." While Jesus was in the temple complex, people who were blind and people who were lame came to him. Jesus healed them. The blind and lame would not have been allowed to worship in the temple. Other religious leaders saw Jesus' miracle and heard the children saying, "Hosanna to the Son of David." They were very angry and asked Jesus, "Do you hear what these children are saying? They were saying Jesus is the king." "Yes," Jesus told them. "The writer of the Psalms had said, 'You have prepared praise from the mouths of children and nursing infants.'" Jesus left them and went to the town of Bethany to spend the night. During Jesus' triumphal entry, the people welcomed him as king. Jesus was the Messiah spoken about by the prophet Zechariah. "Look, your king is coming to you. He is righteous and victorious, humble and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. One day, Jesus will return to earth on a white horse as king over everything."
Hosanna! Jesus the King arrived in Jerusalem.
Man, how cool would it have been to see that?
I know, right?
But did you see the way the religious leaders reacted?
I know, right?
Let's watch this video from Mr. Weber to help us understand why some people reject Jesus.
What are you doing, Ryan?
Dude, I decided I'm gonna play basketball now. So I wanna join this team, and they said to get on the team, I gotta be like, perfect.
You've never played basketball before?
Man, I know exactly what to do. Watch this.
One with the ball, you and me.
Hey Ryan, do you want me to
beast mode?
Dude, why don't you just let me
downtown? This one's for Kobe. Stinking basketball, it's not gonna work, man. I can't do it.
Dude, I could play for you. That's what I'm just trying to tell you.
You mean like playing the game for me?
Yeah, playing the game.
But, like then it's you playing, it's not me playing.
But I'm playing for you. So it's like you playing, but it's me.
And I get the trophy?
Yeah, you get the trophy.
What? Really? So, but wait, you're like perfect? Show me. Oh, he's good! Dude, thanks, man. You are awesome. Yeah.
Downtown! I wasn't supposed to make it.
No matter how hard we try, we can never be good enough without Jesus. We need him to help us always. Give me a yup yup if you believe that.
Yup yup.
It's key passage time, RESkids. Let's take a look at a brand new key passage for this Easter season.
Transferred us into the kingdom of
until you start memorizing that one, RESkids.
Man, this was so much fun. Thanks for letting me help teach today, RESkids. I can't wait to be back again.
We loved having you, Mr. David. We'll see you next time, friends.
Bye!